So welcome back. Now let's try to learn the structure of mitochondria in detail. In structure of mitochondria, we already said that mitochondria is a double membrane bound structure, where the outer membrane of mitochondria is smooth, continuous and freely permeable. So this is the outer membrane of mitochondria. This outer membrane of mitochondria is smooth, continuous and it is freely permeable. Do remember this MCQ. The outer membrane is freely permeable due to presence of protein channel called as porins. Due to presence of porins, the outer membrane of mitochondria is freely permeable, just like the bacterial cell. Okay, the inner membrane of mitochondria is rough and it is thrown into many finger-like projections called as crista. So these are the finger-like projections which are called as crista. Clear? And it is rough due to the presence of stalk particles called as oxysome or F0 F1 particles or subunit of Fernandez. So these are the oxysomes which make the inner membrane of mitochondria rough. So the inner membrane of mitochondria, this is the inner membrane. Inner membrane is rough, thrown into many finger-like processes called as cristae, single crista. So if there are single, then it is called as crista, and as they are multiple, we are mentioning it as cristae. And this inner membrane is selectively permeable. It is selectively permeable. So the outer membrane is freely permeable and the inner membrane is selectively permeable. Now the space between the two membrane is called as outer chamber. So this is the space between the two membranes, this space is called as outer chamber, or it is also called as perimitochondrial space. This space is having the diameter of 60 to 80 angstrom, and it is a site where actually the proton will get concentrated during the process of oxidative phosphorylation. So यही वो जगह है जहाँ पे proton जमा होंगे during the process of oxidative phosphorylation. Now coming to the inner chamber, a space bounded by inner membrane, or the space inside the inner membrane, is called as inner chamber. And this inner chamber is filled by the ground substance or the fluid which is present inside the inner chamber is called as matrix. So the ground substance of mitochondria is actually a matrix. Now inside the matrix we are having mitochondrial own DNA. So here the inside matrix will have mitochondrial DNA, which is a double stranded, single, circular and naked DNA. It will also have their own RNAs एंड इट विल ऑल्सो हैव 70S टाइप ऑफ राइबोसोम्स. सो इनसाइड मैट्रिक्स वी आर हैविंग ऑल द थ्री स्ट्रक्चर. वी आर हैविंग DNA, ओके, RNA एंड 70S टाइप ऑफ राइबोसोम. ड्यू टू दीज थ्री स्ट्रक्चर द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज सेमी ऑटोनोमस सेल ऑर्गेनेल. सो माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज सेमी ऑटोनोमस सेल ऑर्गेनेल एज इट कैन डिवाइड बाय इट्स ओन एंड इट विल डिवाइड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ बाइनरी फिशन. एंड हु विल हेल्प द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया फॉर डिविजन? इट्स ओन DNA. दिस DNA विल हैव इंफॉर्मेशन to how to produce a particular mitochondria, then it will have its own DNA polymerase enzyme to replicate that DNA, and it will have RNA to decode the information, and it will have ribosome to synthesize the protein. So the presence of all these things will make the mitochondria a semi-autonomous cell organelle. It is semi-autonomous because the division actually is controlled by nucleus, and that's why mitochondria is not fully autonomous, it is semi-autonomous. Are you clear for this thing? Then, as this mitochondria is having its own DNA, RNA and 70S type of ribosome, and the outer membrane is freely permeable due to proteins, these all features are similar to bacterial cells. So there is one theory which suggests that mitochondria is actually a prokaryotic cell which lives inside a eukaryotic cell, and that's why mitochondria is also called as cell within cell, or it is also called as endosymbiont of eukaryotic cell. Okay, so as mitochondria is having all the structure which are similar to prokaryotic cell, this is considered as prokaryotic cell into a eukaryotic cell. Now, coming to the matrix, this matrix will have all the necessary enzymes for Krebs cycle. Except one, that is succinate dehydrogenase. This succinate dehydrogenase enzyme is not present in the matrix. It will be present on the inner mitochondrial membrane. Rest all the enzymes which are needed for Krebs cycle are actually present in the matrix of mitochondria. The mitochondrial matrix is very rich in enzymes. There are 70 different types of enzymes which are present in mitochondrial matrix, and that make the mitochondria a very enzyme rich site of the cell. So the maximum enzymes in the cells are present inside the mitochondria, so it is a very rich site for enzyme. Then the matrix will have this DNA. The DNA of mitochondria is circular, double-stranded and naked, and this DNA is responsible for cytoplasmic inheritance. Cytoplasmic inheritance, which is also called as maternal inheritance, because all the mitochondria which we are having inside our body is actually coming from the mother and not from the father. Father has not actually contributed for the mitochondria. See, what's happened in the process of zygote formation, we are having the egg which is coming from the mother, and this egg will have this haploid nucleus. Inside the egg there will be a mitochondria, okay, and whenever the sperm will come and fuse with this egg, the sperm will only give its nucleus to this egg. So this nucleus will get transferred from sperm to the egg, and these two haploid nucleus will get fused and it will form a zygote. This zygote will ultimately get developed into embryo. So all the mitochondria inside our body are actually coming from the mother and father has not contributed for our mitochondria. As they are coming from the mother, this mitochondria, which is having its own DNA, this DNA which is present inside our body is actually coming from the mother. So this is responsible for cytoplasmic inheritance, because this mitochondria is present in cytoplasm, and as it is coming from mother, it is also called as maternal inheritance. So cytoplasmic inheritance is also called as maternal inheritance. ओके, आर यू क्लियर फॉर दिस थिंग? हमने ये कहा कि माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया जो हमारे शरीर में है, वो सारे के सारे माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया हमें हमारी मदर से मिले, फादर के तरफ से हमें माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया नहीं मिले. क्यों? क्योंकि जब जायगोट बना तो जायगोट फॉर्म करने के लिए हमें चाहिए था एग और स्पर्म, और जब स्पर्म आके एग से फ्यूज हुआ तो स्पर्म का तो सिर्फ न्यूक्लियस ही एग को मिला, बाकी सारे जो स्ट्रक्चर थे वो तो मैटरनल एग में ही प्रेजेंट है. तो जो माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया मैटरनल एग में प्रेजेंट था वही जायगोट में प्रेजेंट था, और जायगोट का फिर बना एम्ब्रियो, और एम्ब्रियो से बने हम. इसीलिए हमारे शरीर के सारे माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया जो है वो हमारी मदर से आए. अब माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया जो एग के साइटोप्लाज्म में था, उसके पास अपना खुद का डीएनए था, तो जो डीएनए हमारी मदर के माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया में है वही डीएनए हमारे माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया में है, एंड एज इट इज प्रेजेंट इन साइटोप्लाज्म इट इज कॉल्ड एज साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस, एंड वी आर गेटिंग इट फ्रॉम मदर सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज मैटरनल इनहेरिटेंस. आर यू नाउ क्लियर फॉर दिस थिंग? ओके, देन टॉकिंग अबाउट द ऑक्सीजोम्स और द F0 F1 पार्टिकल्स. These oxysome or the F1 F0 particles are actually a stark particles which consist of a head, then it will have a stalk, and then it will have a base piece. This head will have a diameter of 100 angstrom, and this base piece is actually present in inner membrane, and it will form a tunnel for protein transport. This base piece is called as F0 unit, and this head is called as F1 unit. F0 is a base piece which forms a tunnel for proton transport from outer chamber to inner chamber. So, in this space, there will be a proton during the process of oxidative phosphorylation, and with the help of this tunnel, the proton will go from outer chamber to inner chamber, and whenever they will move from outer chamber to inner chamber, their kinetic energy is harvested in the form of chemical energy, that is ATP. This is actually a chemoosmotic hypothesis which we will learn in the subsequent chapters. So oxysomes are ये जो है वो एक स्टार्क पार्टिकल है जिनको अपना स्टार्क है खुद का. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ हेड, स्टॉक एंड बेस पीस. हेड इज एक्चुअली अ एटीपेज एंजाइम which combines ADP plus IP to form ATP. ADP plus IP to form ATP. And the F0 unit, that is a base piece, is actually a protein tunnel which helps the proton to move from outer chamber to inner chamber. And during their movement, their kinetic energy is harvested in the form of chemical energy, that is ATP. Clear? Now, coming to the functions of mitochondria, what different functions the mitochondria will do inside a cell other than energy extraction, that is ATP production. So, speaking about the functions, number one, the mitochondria is a site for oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation, that is ATP synthesis. Other than this, the mitochondria is responsible for amino acid synthesis and protein synthesis. So, mitochondria will also help in amino acid and protein synthesis. There are so many amino acids which can be intermediate products of Krebs cycle. Clear? And these amino acids are utilized for the production of protein. So, plus mitochondria will also help the cell in lipid synthesis. This is another function which mitochondria will perform in the cell. Speaking about the storage function, the mitochondria will help in the storage of calcium ion. So, mitochondria will also help in storage of calcium ions. Next, mitochondria will help in formation of tail of sperm. So, mitochondria will also help the sperm in formation of tail. Clear? And that tail, that a Nibirkan part of the sperm, will provide continuous energy to sperm for its whirling movement. So, in this way, there are various functions other than ATP production which mitochondria will perform inside the cell. Now, mitochondria is the largest cell organelles in animal cell, but it cannot be visualized until we stain it with a proper dye. So, a dye which is used for staining purpose of mitochondria is Janus Green B. So, this is a particular stain we utilize for staining the mitochondria. If you want to visualize the mitochondria, we have to stain the mitochondria with this particular stain, and then the mitochondria will get visualized to us. So, this is everything regarding the structure and the function of mitochondria. Now, in the next video, we'll try to learn about plastids. Thank you.